Hello, everybody. Collier Swecker in Birmingham, Alabama. Hope you're having an awesome day. Wanted to talk about home flipping and your average home flipper, the folks that are just starting out flipping homes, or they may have done one a few years ago when the market was just awesome and now are getting back into it. And one of the biggest things that I can tell you is this. It, at least here in Birmingham, as we sit in October of 2014, one of the biggest struggles is finding good properties to flip. And what appears to be a good deal is usually, if it's not a competitive situation, is usually not the deal that you're really looking for unless you really know what you're doing. You know, and one of the things I can tell you is that you got to put so much time and effort into the planning stages to make good profits, in my opinion, especially early on in your flipping career, that I'm bringing this to you from experience working with flippers from the brand new to the most experienced. And one of the things that I really know about the most experienced flippers is that they know their numbers very well. They know exactly how much something's going to cost. They know what they can handle, too. That's the other thing, is they know what, if a foundation's bad, they know that they can handle any of those problems or a particular type of foundation problem. That they have vendors that they can go to. They have negotiated pricing. They can really tell from the very beginning, whether they're on the courthouse steps or they're buying a foreclosure, to flip exactly what their costs are and who they're going to use and those type of things. So, you know, really kind of think of that. Make sure you have the right team in place when you start doing this. Not just a handyman, not just your friend Joe that happens to be a brick mason, because what's going to happen is that Joe's going to get real busy and not be able to help you potentially. So you need to make sure you really can, you know, have a number of variety of providers, whether it be of any of the trades. And then also have a backup plan relative to the fact of, okay, am I okay holding this property and holding this cash? Because the rental market is hot. The rental market's very hot right now. And are you okay if you have to rent the property? Because you've come into something unforeseen that's caused you to spend too much money on the flip, would you be okay renting the property out, or do you need the immediate cash out? Because I can tell you this, if you are banking on flipping cash that you have to have, don't flip, because your cash can get stuck real quick. So, and that's what got a lot of people in trouble. These are just a few thoughts on flipping in 2014. If you have any questions, comments, or disagree with anything I've had to say, email me, Collier@megaagents.com. Have an awesome day. Bye-bye.